What's up guys, me Haloraders, back for some more Pokemon Leaf Green. In the last episode, we started the Elite Four and took care of the first Elite Four member, Lorelei. In today's episode, we're going to be taking on the second of the Elite Four, Bruno! So let's go and meet the bastard. Okay, so here he is. Bruno is a fighting type, so clearly you want a Pokemon that knows psychic or flying type moves. However, you don't want to send them out first, because he has two Pokemon which aren't fighting types. And they are Onix. He has two Onix, both at the same level. Level, I think it's 51. 1 level 51 Onix, 1 level 54. And they are both pretty tough. So you want to make sure that you are ready for this. But this one won't be too much of a problem, because not only do I have Whitley and Lamar to take care of those two, but I have Zool and Charlie to take care of the flying fighting types, either with Charlie's fly move or Zool's Dream Eater. So this one won't be much of a problem. Let's get straight into it.
I am Bruno of the Elite Four. Through rigorous training, people and Pokemon can be stronger without limits. I've lived and trained my with my fighting Pokemon, and that will never change. Joe, we will grind you down with our superior power. Hoo-hoar!
He appears to be a farmer. Look at that butch guy. Okay, so this guy is, if you don't really have any flying types or psychic types, you might want to be careful around him, especially if you're using rock-type Pokemon or normal types. But other than that, he shouldn't really be much of a problem. So we're going to throw out a Sunny Day straight away. And Whitley's going to be doing quite a bit of damage here, I do believe. It's using Earthquake. Okay, that might not be too good. We're fine. Okay, so we can pull off a Solar Beam now. Okay, Solar Beam! And that should take care of Onix, because Onix cannot stand up to grass moves that are special attacks. So yeah, there goes Onix. Bye, Onix. And, Whitley, there we go. And then Hitmonchan, okay. So now I'm going to swap out to Zool, and hopefully Zool can stand up to Hitmonchan. I'm not sure Hitmonchan has any stats that would mean Hypnosis can't do anything against it. I bloody hope it doesn't have anything like that, because I'm pretty sure Hitmonchan is not an Insomniac Pokemon. So we're going to use Hypnosis. Hypnosis missed, of course. Of course it missed. It is a Rock Gym. Shit. Understand that? Yeah, it just, that was a crit, so oh, its speeds fell. Okay, that might be a bit worrying. The sunlight is strong. Okay, so let's use Hypnosis again. It's Sky Uppercut. Thank God it missed, right? No! Hypnosis missed! Come on! If I knew I was going to have these problems, I wouldn't have bothered. But Hypnosis is the longest move we've had. Oh, crap. It got Sky Uppercut in. Come on, survive this. Survive this. No. Oh my God, it got a crit. That was really unlucky. Yes! We got Hypnosis in! That means we can now use our Psychic move! Yes! Okay, so let's do that. The sunlight faded. Okay, I'm going to have to do that again if I get Whitley out again. Okay, come on, take care of it, Zool. You can do it. Sap all its health. Sap it up. Get it. Okay, how much is that going to do? It's going to do a lot, hopefully. No, I didn't take it out! That's not good. Its dreams were eaten, though. Okay, can we get another one? Oh, no, it woke up. Shit.
Zool's gone.
It got a crit. It got a crit every time! Every time it didn't attack, it got a crit! What?! That's mad! Oh well, we still got Charlie to take care of it. Maybe that wasn't the best idea to send out Zool, but we can fly it. We can take care of it with Fly. We used Rock Tomb, but Rock Tomb missed. Duh! Okay, so Fly should take care of Hitmonchan. It did. Okay. Good work, Charlie! And then it faints. And then we get all that lovely experience. Machamp, his strongest Pokemon. I'm keeping out Charlie to take care of this. Okay, we're gonna fly, and there it goes, up in the air. Use Scary Face, but that doesn't work when I'm in the air, dumbass. Okay, so how much is that going to... Not very much at all. Crap. Scary Face, what does that do? That doesn't paralyze me, does it? No, it just lowers my speed, thank God. I thought it was one of the paralyzing ones, but it was... Bulk up, crap. Okay, so its defense has gone up. Well, that's not brilliant. Okay, so Charlie goes up into the air. And it uses Rock Tomb. Okay, so they know Rock Tomb, that's bad. No! Shit! Oh, and it had a Citrus Berry, of course it did. Of course it did. Their strongest Pokemon always has a Citrus Berry, right? Okay, so we're gonna Flamethrower. Oh no, please.
Charlie, just survive this. Come on, Charlie. Come on, Charlie. Survive this. No!
Fuck you! Great. Okay, so this is going worse than I was expecting it to. Both my Pokemon that can take out fighting types are down. That's not good. Got Shadow Ball though. Come on, Lamar. Get that Shadow Ball in there. Fucking hell! That was a lot of damage. Oh no. No. Special defense fell crap. Okay, I'm going to use a revive quickly on Charlie because Charlie can take care of it. He's gonna knock out Lamar before Lamar can do anything, so. Or he's going to heal. Was not expecting that actually. Okay, so this is not going as planned, and oh, it missed! Oh, thank God! Come on, Lamar, do loads of damage. You're not gonna take it out. I know you're not, but do loads of damage. Okay, Lamar is going to take it out. I guess I misjudged you, Lamar. Great work! Thumbs up to Lamar, right? Hitmonlee, okay, it's last fighting type. Okay, if we can take care of Hitmonlee, the rest of the battle will be a blast. Okay, so we're going to Surf, and Hitmonlee is using Facade. Crap. Okay, so Lamar's down. But don't worry, we still have Charlie. Charlie can deal with this, right? Come on, Charlie, you can deal with this. We're gonna fly. And there goes Charlie. And Charlie's using Mega Kick. Mega Kick missed, of course, because Charlie's in the air. And Charlie just swoops down, knocks him in the head, and out go the lights for Hitmonlee. Okay, so Hitmonlee's gone. It just has one Pokemon left. This won't be tough. It's an Onix. Okay, so we're going to go switch back to Whitley. Whitley will be able to take care of Onix. Nun problemo. Just hope it does not pull out some shit. Okay, I hope it does not have Flamethrower. If it has fucking Flamethrower, I will be mad as bricks. It has Earthquake. Okay, so that won't do much to Whitley. Okay, and then we get our Solar Beam out, and that Onix gone. Because there's no way it's standing up to Solar Beam. And there we go. The second of the Elite Four is beaten. Thank Christ, right? Thank Christ we got it beaten. Because I was so worried. I was so worried he was going to thrash us there. My job is done. Go face your next challenger! Okay, so he just turns away from us. Oh, you're... asshole. Okay, so we have two Pokemon fainted and two rather hurt, so... When my mouse decides it's going to do stuff, we're going to heal him up. Okay. Okay, so Whitley goes back up to full health, and Charlie goes back up to full health. Now I'm going to have to waste another two revives. That was a pretty tough battle. So, use a revive on them. I'm a bit worried about the next one, because we don't really have any Pokemon that are good against ghost types. But we're going to have to try. Okay. So going to have to use another load of hyper potions. I might not have had enough items. That's something I'm a bit worried about now. I might not have enough items. I might not have trained them up enough. Maybe 52 might have been enough. I don't know. But, okay. So, the next of them is a ghost type. Now, give me a second to figure out what Pokemon she has so I can plan against it. Okay, so I've had a quick look. The next one has two Gengars and a Haunter, as well as an Arbok and Golbat. Arbok and Golbat won't be much of a problem. I can take them out easily. It's the Gengars I'm worried about. Now, I've had a look, and they're weak to four types. Psychic, Ghost, Dark, and Ground. However, Gengar and Haunter all have Levitation, meaning they cannot be hit by Ground-type moves. So technically, it only has three weaknesses. And that's a bit of a problem, because we have a Psychic type, and they're weak to psychic type, but at the same time, they're bound to have moves that can take down a psychic type, and Zul's Hypnosis has a bit of a history of missing. So I'm a bit worried. It is, however, weak to ghost, and we have a ghost type move, and we also have a dark type move, meaning we could take care of this if we want to. So it's gonna sound silly, but I'm gonna be sending out Electra to deal with them. Thief isn't... No, we're not going to send out Electra, because Thief is not a very strong move. That was just a precaution one. We're going to be sending out Lamar, because Lamar's Ghost Attack. He has Shadow Ball, which is a pretty good Ghost-type move, so we're going to be taking care of it with that. Okay, so here she is. I'm just going to save quickly, and then we can continue. Okay, so I'm a bit worried about this one, as you know, but hopefully Lamar can do this for me. Come on. We can do this, Lamar. Let's go.
I am Agatha of the Elite Four. I hear Oak's taken a lot of interest in you, child. That old duff was once thought and handsome, tough and handsome, but that was decades ago. He's a shadow's former self. Now he just wants to fiddle with his Pokedex.
I think that might be an innuendo.
He's wrong. Pokemon are for battling. Joe, I'll show you how a real trainer battles. Ooh, I'm an old lady.
Here we are, Agatha, the third of the Elite Four. This is probably one of the ones I'm most worried about because of ghost types. But I believe in Lamar, and it gets a double team straight away. Shit, that should have been. Okay, come on, Lamar. You can hit it still. Yes, he got the hit in. Come on, knock it out straight away, please. No, of course not. Okay, we're gonna try Surf. It's gonna Shadow Punch. Okay, how much? That's not done much. And Surf got in. That's a good start. Okay, come on, take it out. Yes. Okay, Surf might be the way to go then. Okay, so it's gonna send out Golbat. We're gonna switch to Electra because Golbat is of the flying type. Electra can take care of it. Okay, so we have got ourselves a Golbat, and we have got ourselves a Thunderbolt. Bye, Golbat! Bye! Bye. I'm waving my hand at you. Bye! Bye. Hand says bye too. Okay, we're going to switch out to Carter. This may sound like a silly thing, but we're going to switch out to Carter because she's sending out a poison type and Carter has a ground type move and we should be able to wipe it out. Okay, so it's used its Intimidate on us and we are going to use our Earthquake on it. Bye, Arbok! Bye! Bye! But it survived! Well, I look like a fool! And I a fool! Okay, so we're using Earthquake again. Pardon me. And, Arbok is gone. Bye, Arbok! Bye! I don't know why I'm doing that. Okay, so now Carter is now our highest level Pokemon. That's kind of funny, because I remember him being quite a low level Pokemon. No, we don't want to learn Reversal. No. Okay, stop learning Reversal, yes. Not learn Reversal. Okay. So now she's sending out her highest level Pokemon, Gengar. We're going to switch back to Lamar, and we're going to try Surf again, see how much we can get done there. I don't want to use Hypno, because Gengar is almost certainly going to take it out in one go. Sludge Bomb, okay. Might be bad. Oh no, we survived, thank God. And we got a Surf in. Come on, take care of a lot of Gengar's health. Yes! It has a Citrus Berry, of course. Of course, that's no surprise at all. Got a lot of health back there. Sludge Bomb again, Christ. That's bad. It's a lot of health gone. Oh my God! No, she's going to heal, so we may as well take advantage of this too and heal ourselves. Because she's just going to heal him, because that's the only Pokemon she hasn't healed so far. Okay, so there we go. She's healed. Of course she did. I know these Pokemon too well. That's her strongest Pokemon. She wouldn't let it go just like that. Okay, so we're going to try Surf again, because that's clearly our best move, and it knows Sludge Bomb, so that's... It's doing a good amount of damage, but it's not a super effective... It poisoned us for shit. Of course it did. Okay, so Surf should take down enough of its health. It should stop it being too much of a problem. Yeah, if we can get another Surf in next turn, then it won't... It will be gone. It's got a Sludge Bomb again, but we can stand out to that. We can take care of that. And, yeah, we did. We stood up to it. And there goes Gengar! Bye, Gengar! You were really worrying, but I managed to take care of you rather well, actually, so I'm not too worried anymore. Bye! Okay, Haunter. We're going to swap Pokemon. And we're going to send out Zul, because I keep saying that Zul is not going to stand up to any of these Pokemon, but I just want to see what will happen. I want to prove that Zul is not going to be useless in this. Zul stays awake, thank Swim Stomach, thank God. And we got a Hypnosis on it! Woohoo! Stupid. Okay, so yeah, that's one thing you have to watch out for, Haunter and Gengar. Okay, it's still asleep, we can get this attack in. And it's weak to Psychic, thank God, so this will do good. And we've just sapped up its health. Come on. Oh yeah! Zul was not useless this game then! Great work, Zul! Okay. How much experience did you get? Not very much, though. It's kind of sad because it's on that one.
Oh my, you're something special, child!
Joe got $5,800 for winning! Yay!
You win! I see what the old duff says in you now. I have nothing else to say. Run along now, child!
Oh, her voice is great.
You win! I see what the old duff has to say. I have nothing else to say. Run along now, child!
Great voice. She is the queen. Okay, so Lamar took most of the damage in that, so it's kind of fair that Lamar takes on most of the damage in the next one! Okay, so now we've just got one Elite Four member left to take care of, but we will be doing that in the next episode, because I no longer have time today, so it's going to take at least 3 or 4 episodes to beat the Elite Four then. But so far, it's not doing too bad. None of our Pokemon have been absolutely thrashed. We haven't come close to failing yet. We've lost one or two Pokemon in one battle, but we've been able to stand up to them, and the toughest so far has actually been Bruno, which I thought would be the easiest. The next one, though, is not going to be easy, and it's definitely one that's worrying me, so I'll see you all next time when we've beaten the Elite Four. Haloraders Out!